Thank you so much for joining us again in a session that CIO East Africa is hosting among a series of webinars that we are having in 2021. Now, today's event is a very special one. We are talking about enhancing digitization in the various industry spaces that we are engaged in. It is so timely that you could spare our time to join us in this 1 hour session. Why is today's a very unique session? We have key partners who will be co-convening this session, and that is Computec and Huawei Technologies. I will shortly introduce our anchor who will again also introduce our key speakers for the day. Very prolific speakers who you will enjoy their interaction day. I would also like to urge us this afternoon to stay on, because besides the invaluable discussion that we are going to have this afternoon, we are also going to take home some very, very special giftings on the background that 5G trials have just been launched in this country. So hold on with us from the onset, as you have. And thanks again for joining. And walk with us all the way to the end. Now, allow me to introduce to us Job Motegi, the Regional Marketing Manager of Computec. Job, please usher in our prolific speakers.
Thank you, Humphrey, for the introduction. So I hope you guys are excited as we are for the 5G launch and Air Engine Wi-Fi 6 being something that will leverage on this. So I would like to introduce Stephen Miner, who is the head of security and networking at Computec Limited. And he'll walk you through on about Computec being a prolific partner, Huawei partner, and a gold partner. And we'll move forward to Matamela, who is the CTO of Huawei, who will walk you through on how to digitize your industry with Air Engine Wi-Fi 6. So on to you, Stephen.
Thank you very much, Job. Thank you, Humphrey, for the introduction as well. And welcome, everyone, to this very lovely webinar that we've organized for today. And the heading for today will be on how to enhance digitalization in organizations using Huawei's Air Engine 6. So my name is Stephen Miner. I head the network and security department at Computec. That means that I take care of both the technical teams, and I also take care of the sales side of matters. So what does digitalization mean to you and your organization? This is the question that each one of us needs to ask themselves. Because for each industry, digitalization means a completely different thing. If you're in the manufacturing industry, maybe it means automation of a certain process. If you're in the banking and financial sector, maybe there's another process that needs to be digitalized. And if you're in retail, something else. And even in the general enterprise, you'll find that digitalization means something different for you. But for digital transformation to be successful, I think we can all agree that it requires a change in processes. And more importantly, it requires a change in the way we think. And this is not just to ourselves, but the entire organization. So organizations that have been able to undergo successful digital transformation find that partnering with key technology outsourcers like Computec actually plays a very big role. So what will Computec do for you? So Computec offers a very smart digitalization plan that will enable your organization to adopt new technologies that will help you to overcome business challenges. And this digitalization will help your organization open newer avenues of innovation for your businesses, and in turn, improving your products and your services, which are very key, and then at the end of the day, boosting your returns. So before Matamela discusses about the Huawei Engine Air 6, I'll just provide a quick brief on Computec. So Computec is an organization that has been in existence for the last 34 years. And we have branches in 5 countries. That's Kenya, Uganda, Tanzania, Rwanda, and Zambia. And I'm sure most of you that have joined this webinar have heard of Computec somewhere, or are even currently working with Computec on certain projects, or you've worked with Computec before. And in even some instances, some of you have actually worked for Computec. So Computec portfolio. So what do we have? So the major departments in our organizations are 6. The first one is the enterprise department. So the enterprise department deals with your data centers, whether it's your physical data centers, your cooling, your power, your raised floors, container data centers. That's all part of the enterprise. But we also have your normal server storage, virtualization and consolidation. You also have backup solutions. We have the networking department. And also we have the security and cybersecurity teams that also fall under the enterprise department. So we partner with a couple of vendors, but Huawei is actually one of the main vendors that we partner with on the enterprise side. On the software side, we are a partner for Microsoft 365, and we are also a reseller for Azure Cloud. We also have core banking softwares and ERPs, and we also have custom-made softwares that we give to our customers. A key thing that I'd like to mention is we've also recently introduced RPA, which is Robotics Process Automation, and we've actually seen a lot of interest from customers, whereby we are able to come in and identify a process that probably is being done but currently requires human intervention. But using robots and automation of the whole process, you'll find that a task that was being done by someone for 3 days, because probably it's just a data entry task, now is being automated and being done by a system that does it probably for 2 to 3 minutes. So that form of digitalization is what we're offering our customers. So we also have a service department. So the service department actually deals with contracts, whether it's your professional services, whether it's your SLAs, whether it's managed services. We also have an outsource department, which is part of the services contract, where we come in and take care of all your IT needs. We also have a UX, user experience department. So this one will primarily to deal with end compute devices. So we resell laptops, PCs, whether it's accessories, printers, scanners, ATMs, we all have all that solution. And then we also have a cabling department that basically does structured cabling and IP surveillance. And finally, we have a leasing department. So the leasing department from Computec is something that over the last year, I think since COVID started, has gained a lot of traction, because more and more it's becoming very difficult for organizations to run on a CapEx model, because you find that getting approved for budgets to maybe you're overdue for a network upgrade, or your server storage is end of support, so you need to do an upgrade. But with COVID came a lot of financial restrictions, and so many organizations are not able to spend on what they actually need for their IT. But Computec offers a leasing model where a customer does not require putting any money before purchasing anything. Like, it's, you just come in, there is no initial installment. So the only thing that you'll be required to pay is the monthly installment, which is very flexible, whether it's a 1-year payment plan, whether it's 2 years, up to 5 years, Computec is able to offer that. So that's something that we've seen even large organizations that you traditionally would not think would look at such options. But because of the implications that COVID has brought, this is something that is gaining a lot of traction. And if you have any queries regarding how this can be done, you can get in contact with us. So as I explained, our product and services portfolio landscape is as indicated. So on the communication infrastructure, we have your structured cabling, we have your surveillance, we have physical security, we have your networking and security solutions, and also what has become very, very important is collaboration. Guys are working from home now, so meetings need to be had, conversations between colleagues are very critical now, and then access to resources which are located from your office or in remote branches also becomes very critical. So this forms part of what we call secure workforce and collaboration. So collaboration playing a very important role in that. And then on the data center side of things, we have the data center built. Like I said, we actually do build data centers for customers. And then we have your compute storage, we have your backup solutions, we have the consolidation. We also do virtual desktop, the VDI. And the service management platform is what we call services earlier. So it includes the SLA for all your infrastructure, all your hardware and software as well. We're able to come in and you can use our highly skilled engineers for escalation of tickets that maybe your team has been unable to assist with. Then we can come in and look at that. We also do project management, security management. We also do MDM and cloud management, infrastructure management. And if you have any question, I just forgot to say, if you have any question at any particular point, feel free to ask. We are here to have a conversation. So our value proposition for networking and security. So basically, we cover data center. We cover both your data center and your campus and your WAN. Something that I've seen so many customers interested in currently is software defined. I think everyone is looking at how they can transform, whether it's their security, whether it's their networks, using software defined technologies. SD-WAN has gained a lot of traction. I think most organizations, I think there are a couple of some big customers who've already moved all their branches from traditional MPLS connections to a more software defined connection, which is bringing in a lot of savings to customers. Because if you compare the cost of paying for a dedicated MPLS link to all your branches and the SD-WAN cost, which relies on the internet for connectivity, you'll find that the gains are very much clear. So organizations are benefiting a lot from moving to software, the software-defined world, which is a very big step in this digital transformation. So on professional services, Computec is able to give you design and consultancy for professional services. So we can be able, if you're looking at coming up with a solution, we are able to send our team to come and do, first of all, we actually do free assessments of what you have in your current environment. So this will cover your network, your security, your server storage and virtualization. And we've been very successful with customers who've done this. And in some instances, we've been able to help them save more because you find that possibly they've been paying for some licenses that are not being utilized, or they were paying for more licenses than they actually required. And it's actually a free consultancy. It's something that you can just call us. We'll schedule with you whenever you're available. We come in and then we do the assessment and we give a report to you. Then whatever you choose to do with the report, it does not mean that you have to work with Computec. Of course, we'll feel better if you work with us, but it's not mandatory that you work with us. The free assessment is something that we just offer to our customers. So feel free to engage us. If you feel that there's a certain pain point that you've been having that possibly your team has not been able to identify, or because you might end up buying a device or a product thinking that it's going to solve a certain pain point, then in the end, you'll find that you spent a lot of money not addressing that pain point, but rather buying another product that comes on and does not become of value add to you. So the free assessment is something that I encourage all of you to take advantage of, and we can schedule that as quickly as possible. So when it comes to Huawei, Computec is actually a Forrester Gold partner. We've been working with Huawei for very many years. We are actually a certified service partner for Huawei, meaning that we can take care of both installations as well as support. We have engineers who are certified for servers. We have engineers who are certified for storage. We have engineers who are certified for your networking requirements as well. So some of our key customers include guys like KRA, we have KCB, we have NCBA, we have the Capital Markets Authority, ICLOF, and then a long list of customers. I think Huawei solutions nowadays are, the innovation is very clear. In the past, we used to rely only on few vendors to really offer innovation. But if you look at what Huawei is doing, it's quite special. They have so many amazing technologies that if you take leverage of, you'll find that there's true benefit in them. And I think with that, I'd like to, unless there's a question, I'd like to hand it over to Mr. Matamela for him to take us through now the technical discussion around the Huawei Air Engine's Wi-Fi 6 and how it can transform your environments. Welcome, Mr. Matamela.
So I'd like to introduce him. We are lucky to be graced with Mr. Matamela, who is the CTO of Huawei. So he will walk us through on how to digitalize your industry with the Huawei Engine Wi-Fi 6.
About Huawei Wi-Fi 6 solution, how it can help and transform your industry. The agenda is going to be divided into three parts. The first part is about Huawei Enterprise Network Overview. The second part is about Huawei Wi-Fi 6 solution. And the third part is about successful case studies. Now, if you look at this slide here, I would like to share with you our enterprise leading solution into the market. Huawei has been innovating for a long time. Huawei is number one when coming to the innovation. And we can see that we have a lot of innovation coming in from our routers. When looking at the global market share, we are number one. When looking at the edge routers, we are number two globally. When looking at the Ethernet switching, we are number two globally. And looking at our rapid growth from different technologies over the years, you can see that our accumulated compound annual growth rate for the data center, we've been growing by 82%. And on our wireless LAN solution, we are growing at 53%. On our Wi-Fi solution, we're growing at 25%. Now, here I just want to introduce our network product overview. Firstly, I would like to talk about the four engines that we have that runs our enterprise network. The first one is the Air Engine. The Air Engine is the engine that runs on our Wi-Fi solutions, on our APs, on our wireless LAN controllers. These are the engines that provide the wireless connectivity, the wireless solution for the customers. The second one is our Net Engine. This is the engines that runs on our routers, whether it's a service provider routers or an enterprise routers, we use the Net Engine routers. And the third one is a Cloud Engine. This is the engine that runs on our data center switches and also on our campus switches. The last one is the HiSec engines that runs on our security solutions, whether we are talking about the Wi-Fi, the firewall solutions, or you are talking about the anti-DDoS, the fire hunters, which is the sandboxes. This is the HiSec engines that runs on our security devices. And when coming back to the Air Engines, the one that we're going to be talking about and we're going to be drilling lot of times around this, we see that when looking at the Wi-Fi 6 standard, Huawei has been a number one contributor when coming to the development of Wi-Fi 6 standard. And looking at the market share, we are number one when coming to the Wi-Fi 6 market share. And we won even the Gartner Peer Insight Customer Choice Award for 2019 and 2020 with our Wi-Fi solutions. On our Net Engines, coming to the contribution of segment routing over V6 standard, we are number one. We are the leader when coming to the contribution and the development of the standard of the segment routing. And this is the solution that is needed for our service provider and the large corporate as well. And we are number one with looking at the global market share around our routers, 31%. And we won even the best show award of the 2019 around our routers. Cloud Engine, we're the first one in the market to come up with the data center switches with the AI chipset, where we can provide a data center with the first intelligent and the lowest data center network with zero packet loss using our Cloud Engine solution. And Our compound annual growth rate increases by 83% over the years, and we won Customer Choice Award from the Gartner for 2019 and 2020 around that. HiSec engine, which is our, we are the champion when coming to the AI firewalls. We are the first one to come up with the AI firewalls into the market, and even the third party testing vendors like NSS Lab, they recommend us when coming to the threat accuracy protection around our firewalls. And we are the leader, and we've been recommended, and we've been tested among other security vendors, and we came on top around that. And let's talk about the Wi-Fi solution itself. How can Wi-Fi 6 transform the enterprise? How can it digitize and transform the industry? And we see that Wi-Fi becomes a foundation to be able to transform the industry around that. But let me share with you some research that was done by the Forbes report and even Accenture. According to the Forbes report, they say that 16% of enterprises succeed in digital transformation. And this is very concerning. Where is the rest of the percentage? Where is the rest of the organizations? Because everything at the moment, it needs to be digitized. We are in a fourth industrial revolution where we need to digitize everything. 44% of the business leaders believe that the lack of digital skills is the key obstacles to digital transformation. This is the report coming from the Accenture Strategic Executive Research. And looking at the key factors for the enterprise digital transformation, the first one is about learning-oriented organization. In other words, we need to keep on improving our digital skills. We need to keep learning a new skills in the industry. The second one is about effective collaboration. Quick communication and decision-making is very important. And the last one is about fast time to market our services, our solutions into the market. And in order to realize those key digitized transformation, network is the foundation. Networks becomes a pillar. Wi-Fi becomes a foundation to deployment or to the construction of the entire network. And we see that Huawei can provide what we call it all wireless scenario, creating an always on learning and collaborative environment. The second one is the convergence of the IoT and Wi-Fi, building a smart office space and personalized environment, which we are going to share with you some use cases around that. And the last one is about the AI. All our solutions are developed with the AI. The AI can be able to help you with the first time to provisions and first time to market your solutions. And you can provide a lot of services and the teaming up and the sharing of the information through that. But Wi-Fi 6 can bring, what Wi-Fi 6 brings into the market? There are major pain points that in the enterprises where Wi-Fi can be able to help. And this can deliver a breakthrough in a core technologies for a new application and scenarios and involve from the best efforts and to the guaranteed services. Three fundamental steps or three fundamental points that Wi-Fi 6 trying to solve into the market. The first one is massive connection. We know that we are living in an IoT era where all things need to be connected on the network. And we see a lot and lots of devices that needs to connect to the network. And Wi-Fi 6 can be able to help to connect so many devices within a single AP. And this can help with the massive connections. The second one is the high capacity. More, we see more and more applications that are bandwidth hungry, like, for example, VDI, VR, video, which needs 8K and needs a lot of bandwidth. Wi-Fi 6 can be able to solve that kind of a problem. The third one is about low latency. Lot of applications are delay sensitive. They need low latency, like the VDI, like the VR, all of this, like AGV, automated guided vehicles. They need a low latency, and Wi-Fi 6 can be able to help to solve these kind of problems. Now, the second one, what 5.56 can bring to solve into the market is convergence of Wi-Fi and IoT to reduce the network construction and maintenance cost. We see as is at the moment, most of the enterprises, they built a separate and silos network. Whether it's a wireless office network, you find that it is siloed. A dedicated IoT, if they want to embark on the IoT project, they need to build an IoT dedicated network. And for the video surveillance and all that, it's a different network altogether. And these result in a high network construction and maintenance cost. And we see a lot of interference between this wireless environment. We've got a solution that will be able to help, which is our Wi-Fi 6. With our Wi-Fi 6 AP, you can integrate the RFID, ZigBee, and the Bluetooth on one solution. By doing that, you reduce the TCO by 50%. And the interference detections and the increased rate of the IoT and the network capacity, it can reach up to 100%. And we've got a way of detecting the interference on that wireless environment without any problem. In other words, which means you want to use it for different scenarios or for the electronic shelf labeling or for the infant preventions or for the student management, you can use it for different scenarios altogether for different market. This is the solution that you can use. The second one, the Wi-Fi 6 can bring into the market and can be able to help is about proactive operation and maintenance platform that integrates the management, the control, and the analysis to help to implement fault locating within minutes, moving away from a passive response and maintenance. And we know that most of the time, 90% of faults are driven by the complaints from the customer. And the network guys, they're not aware that there's a problem on the network. Fault location and demarcating, it can take days or hours. And it is difficult to rectify the problems and it takes more days. And the optimization, the network optimization is done manually. But with our operation and maintenance, which is more proactive, which we call it iMaster NCE, it can be able to help you to be more preventative and predictive maintenance and provide the predictive maintenance and real-time SLA awareness and demarcate and locate more than 85% of the faults within minutes. And these are championed and we use an AI algorithm based on the automatic optimization. In other words, we can optimize your network. You can optimize your Wi-Fi solution automatically using our iMaster NCE because we use telemetry, and telemetry, we get information in real time. And it is intent-based. Everything is automated and we provide a closed loop. And we can provide an automatic network optimization or optimized network optimization automatically soon. And I want to share with you some use cases that we have. Like in Huawei, we say that drink your own champagne. We drink our own champagne with our Wi-Fi 6. We have deployed Wi-Fi 6 into our environment. You know that Huawei is contributing in more than 170 countries and regions. We've got presence in all of these countries. And we've got offices, more than two or four offices around the country. And we've got more than 194,000 employees. And each employee has more than two devices. And with these devices, all of them are connected through Wi-Fi. And the one that I want to share with you using our Wi-Fi on our office space, and we call it digital office, improving the office efficiency and transforming our office experience for the users to enjoy the Wi-Fi connectivity and to enjoy the massive connectivity and the bandwidth that the Wi-Fi 6 comes with. In other words, in our offices, you just come into the office and you just sit there with your laptop, whether it's in the boardroom or in the office. You can see on the right-hand side, this is our boardroom where the overhead projector is connected to the Wi-Fi. The screen is connected onto the Wi-Fi. Everything is connected on the Wi-Fi. Everything is Wi-Fi'd. And if you visit our offices, you will see that you won't see any Ethernet cable on our desk. The only cable that you will see is just for the power. We are just waiting for that time where we can have a wireless power into even on the laptops and on the devices. And gone would be cables in the desk. And you can see that Huawei has built a Wi-Fi 6 based on the global digital office space, supporting 15,000 HD smart screens, allowing more than 7.25 billion instant messages, 4.5 billion emails, 15 millions of IPs and video conferencing per month. All of these are going through our Wi-Fi solution, which is our AP. We also digitize the production, digitize the manufacturing. The one that I want to highlight there is Quicktron, the manufacturing plant. The space of the manufacturing plant is about 20 to 30,000 square meters. And they've got more than 1,000 AGV. These are robotic cars that they move from one place to another, moving the different goods from one place to another and packing them and all that. And they use Wi-Fi 6 in order to provide connectivity. And when deploying Wi-Fi 6 on this, and they saw a lot of reduction of the disconnection of this AGV. And there was 0% or zero packet loss when these machines move from one place to another. And the capacity was increased, for they put more of the AGV devices on this. And the service were 100% with no interruption around the services around that. Now, the other one that I want to highlight when using the Wi-Fi 6 is about digital services for the smart asset management. You can use Wi-Fi 6 with the RFID and take the devices that you want to take or to monitor or to trace. And you can be able to pinpoint where the devices is and you can locate it. When the device moves from one place to another, you can be able to tell it where it is. And this is through the convergence of the IoT and the Wi-Fi into one. And we can improve the customer satisfaction around that. And we've got a management system that can manage up to 280,000 valuable assets around the globe. And this is the solution that we're using internally in Huawei as well. And we can also use this for the other customers as well. Now, I just want to highlight the technologies that makes Wi-Fi 6. What are the technologies that we have? As I said, Huawei is the key innovator. We have innovated. We are number one when coming to the Wi-Fi 6 standard contribution around that. And looking at the innovation part, we use our own chips up our Wi-Fi. Second one that I want to highlight is about advanced radio calibration algorithm, where, for example, when you want to deploy a Wi-Fi solution into your offices, you just need to plug your APs wherever you want to plug them. You don't have to worry about the overlapping channel and all that. The Wi-Fi, the Wi-Fi 6, the advanced radio calibration channels to check whether there's any interference on all that. That is done automatically. You don't have to design your channels. It will be designed for you. The third one is about smart antenna. Each AP is got 16 antennas, the highest antennas in the industry at the moment. And each antenna is got 4 elements. And the more the elements you have, the stronger the signal superposition performance you will have. And it uses 2 to the power of 48 different directional combination in order to provide the signal coverage. What is the benefit of that? With the smart antenna, it allows the users to optimize the coverage. And the last one is about the AI-based operation and maintenance, using our iMaster NCE to provide a proactive operation and maintenance. And we provide a lightning speed, the highest industry performance bandwidth in the market, 10.75 gig AP in the market. No one has that. It's only Huawei that has. We can provide always on experience, service assurance. When users access the applications through the Wi-Fi, we can provide a zero packet loss with our solution. Our iMaster NCE can provide proactive operation and maintenance, which integrate the management, the control, and analysis into one solution. And we call it 4-in-1. I just want to give an example with other vendors of this world, the likes of Cisco and the others. For example, if you want to deploy network admission control from Huawei, you've got only one single dashboard, one solution, which is iMaster NCE, which is our next solution. You want to deploy SD access on your campus, you use iMaster NCE solution, a single dashboard, a single pane of glass for your SD access. You want to manage your firewalls, your security devices, you use a single management, single dashboard, which is our iMaster NCE. You want to deploy the SD-WAN solution. It is a single management solution for your SD-WAN solution, 4-in-1. Whereas other vendors, they are in silos. You need different management solution for different technologies or for different solution that you want to manage. By having iMaster NCE in your environment, you can reduce the TCO by 60%. The second one highlight that I want to highlight is about proactive maintenance on and maintenance using a industry unique protocol tracing that is embedded into our iMaster NCE Campus Insight, where if the user wants to access the network through Wi-Fi and is experiencing a problem, we can be able automatically be able to tell him or her where the problem is, whether he's connecting through 802.1x or portal authentication or doing MAC address authentication. We can be able to demarcate the problem fast, quick, and locate more than 85% of issues within minutes. This is the solution that we have. And we can optimize your Wi-Fi solution. We call it intelligent radio calibration. Achieving 58% of a better white performance for the fine tuning for any interference into the network. You know that most of the times we've got a lot of rogue APs or rogue devices like microwave that interfere with the Wi-Fi and all those kind of things. Our iMaster NCE, our intelligent radio calibration with the wireless LAN controller will be able to do that function automatically. So that's the reason why we say we can be able to provide 100 meg to each and every device everywhere through our Wi-Fi. This is the solution that we can provide. Now, I just want to give some comparison from our Wi-Fi 6 solution and other industry vendors' Wi-Fi solution. Let's look at the special streams. We've got the highest antennas into the market. 16 special streams that we can provide, which is the highest in the industry. And if you compare our Wi-Fi 6 with the industry Wi-Fi 6, on the 5 gigahertz, the industry Wi-Fi 6, they can provide 8 transmit and 8 receive. But with Huawei Wi-Fi 6 solution, on the 5 gigahertz, we can provide 12 transmit and 12 receive, which is more special streams compared to the industry Wi-Fi 6, which is about 1.5 times around that. Effective frequency bandwidth. I just want to highlight on a 160 megahertz, the industry Wi-Fi, they can only provide 4 transmit and 4 receive at 160 megahertz per second. But using a Huawei Wi-Fi solution on a 160 megahertz, we can provide 8 transmit and 8 receive, which is two times or twice effective frequency bandwidth compared to the industry. In other words, our solution, our Wi-Fi solution, is much more better than the industry Wi-Fi that we have in the industry at the moment. Now, let's look at the technology that comes with the Wi-Fi 6 that we have borrowed out from the 5G technology. And everyone in the market, even the guys in the industry, in the street, they know that Huawei are the champion when coming to the 5G. But we have taken the Wi-Fi, the 5G technology, and we've embedded in on our Wi-Fi 6 technology. I just want to highlight some of those technology. The first one that I've alluded to is the smart antenna. With a smart antenna, we can provide the most stable Wi-Fi coverage with zero coverage holes, without any coverage holes. And the signals will move with the users. If, for example, you are in the office space environment and you are connecting through the Wi-Fi, maybe you are having a video conferencing or a voice call, using our Wi-Fi solution, you can move from one place to another and you can roam from one place to another without any problem. And we can provide even 20% more coverage distance using our smart antenna. The second technology that I want to highlight is the dynamic table. Dynamic table is the one that provides the most stable application with the low latency. We use a technology or an algorithm called a multi-queue packet slicing, or a multi-queue packet scheduling acceleration algorithm. With this, we can be able to identify the applications. We can identify the type of users, whether it's a VIP user or just a common or ordinary user. And based on that, we've got more than 6,000 applications that we can identify within our solution. And based on that, we can be able to prioritize which application and which user, whether it's a VIP users accessing a specific application, and we can prioritize those application, and we can provide as low as 10 millisecond latency when the user access the applications to provide a good user experience. The last one I want to highlight is the lawless roaming. When user roam from one place to another, we can provide a zero packet loss during the roaming. Same applies when I showed you on that user case of the AGV, when roaming from one place to another on that manufacturing plant. Lot of AGV roaming from one place, moving from one place to another, connected through Wi-Fi technology. And we can provide zero packet loss. And they can move from one place to another, roam from one AP to another AP without any signal loss or without any packet loss. Huawei has already won a lot of projects into the market. And we are number one when coming to the deployment or the market share of Wi-Fi 6. We've got a lot of projects that we've done through the globe, whether in Africa, Middle East, Asia, Latin America, Europe, you can name them. We've got a lot of them. And we won even Gartner Peer Insight Award for 2020 with our solution, with our Wi-Fi 6, which we call it Cloud Campus solution. Here, they were testing our solution together with other vendors, the likes of Cisco, Aruba, and HP, H3C. And what they did is that they use our solution, our campus solution, the iMaster NCE that provide a management solution and integration of the management control and analysis, and using our Wi-Fi 6 APs and our campus switches. And they tested us among other peers, and we came on top. Our overall rating was 4.7, which is much more better than the rest. In other words, which means we are the best. We've got the innovative solution. We've got a proper solution that the enterprises, they can be able to deploy into their environment, and it can be able to help to transform their businesses. This slide here that you see just summarizes our Wi-Fi product solution that we have. We've got the APs that are dedicated for the vehicles or the train, which you can mount it on the vehicles on the trains. Yes, this you can use it to provide the services, the Wi-Fi, when you are on the go on the road. And we've got other different APs that you can use it for the retails, for the hotels, for the ward, for the dormitory, or for the hotels, or for the wards in the hospitals, or for the residents, for the student res. That's the word that I was looking for. Or you can use it, others, you can use it for the auditoriums, or for the departure, for the departure halls, into for the departure halls, or you can use it for the outdoor APs as well. We have the outdoor APs that you can use it for the stadiums, or for the court, and for the outside environment. And we've got the top APs that you can use it for the in the education scenario, for the classrooms or for the conference rooms or for the high density area. We've got different kind of APs that you can use it for the different scenarios and different times that you can use, you can choose from. And that's it for me from the Wi-Fi 6 solutions. If there's any questions, I will open up for the questions and answers.